I have to be honest, this is the first time I've spoken about boob jobs on this show. Do you remember back in the 90s, it would sort of be gossip about, you know, who's had one? But these days, it's not really something that tends to make headlines. So when Deputy Leader Angela Rayner revealed at the weekend that she went under the knife for the cosmetic op 12 years ago, not many people batted an eyelid. In a candid interview with the Financial Times, she discussed how she borrowed £5,600 from a bank for the procedure, saying, "I had my boob job on my 30th birthday. I'd lost 6 stone thanks to my personal trainer, but my boobs just looked like 2 boiled eggs in socks. You know, like basset hound ears. You can't be 30 and have a chest like an 84-year-old granny. I had spent about 14 months losing my baby weight. I was 17 stone after I had children." Now, lots of people have shrugged this off, of course, but, I mean, they're quite derogatory comments in some ways. And one of our most famous female politicians, the former Tory minister and Daily Express columnist Anne Widdecombe, thinks the admission could actually prove quite damaging. She believes Rayner's busty revelations undermines formidable female politicians of the past, like Thatcher, like Barbara Castle and Shirley Williams, by making the green benches a mere fashion parade. So Anne joins me now. Anne, look, don't used to talk about boob jobs on the show. I'm blaming you for that. But you thought this was inappropriate from Rayner as the woman who wants to become our next Deputy Prime Minister?
Yes. I mean, the comparison that I made was that I, like everybody else, I watched the Remembrance Service at the weekend. And Dame Janet Fuchs, who is a former Deputy Speaker of the House of Commons, at the age of 80, is walking at the head of the War Widows Association. And she walked the whole way from Trafalgar Square to the Cenotaph and had been standing around for a long time before that, probably, and just did it and got on with it, even at that age. And I look at the stature of the politicians in the past, and I look at the utter trivia that they talk now, and I do think it represents a huge diminution of quality. There were only 41 women MPs in the whole House of Commons when I got in 1987. But they were very, very high quality. There hadn't been any positive discrimination. They got there because they had to beat the men on an entirely level playing field. There were no special allowances made for them. And they were formidable people. And don't forget, you listed some, don't forget Betty Boothroyd. They were formidable women. And I feel that the huge emphasis that has been on getting women into the House of Commons at all costs has actually led to a huge diminution in quality. And as I put it, well, it's now full of mini-skirted wonders.
Well, yeah, and she's talking about, you know, having a chest like an 84-year-old granny. I mean, can we just be honest, Anne, and say that this is a really tacky woman? You know, it's a woman who refers to all Tories as scum. I mean, I just feel like we can't accept that sort of language as normal from a politician. It's tacky, isn't it? She's tacky. She's tawdry.
But she's coarse. I mean, that's what it comes down to. She's very, very coarse of speech. And as I say, I think it, it goes against what should be a very dignified approach. Mm-hmm.
What about the counter-argument, Anne, though, that it connects with ordinary voters?
Well, I'm sure that, you know, it may connect with ordinary voters if you put it in a slightly different way and don't make quite such a thing of it. But when you actually, I mean, I don't think ordinary voters would use that sort of language for a start. I don't think most ordinary voters want to know the details of what she looked like or what she thinks she looked like. In a way, I think it's a wrong priority. I mean, there are many things that people should be focusing on rather than simply looks and appearance and, you know, what happens after you've lost a lot of weight.
No, indeed. Well, Anne Widdecombe, you always have the best political analysis. Sorry, I mean best. I'm blaming my team for that, Anne. I'm blaming my team for that, who are responsible for the incredible graphic below you, which I didn't know was going to appear.
Now, it's a very weak person who blames their underlings for what they've done. A very weak person indeed. It's like an MP.
I wish I was that clever. No, Anne, I wish I was that clever to come up with that. It's brilliant. It's had me chortling throughout the interview. But Anne, very serious point.